Okay. Now, funding them. Right? So you know now the five, well, you know four of the five different ways to get start to invest in real estate. We already know this. Wholesaling, mismanaged facilities, cash flowing properties, new construction, and the final one is developing. Develop or conversions, which is kind of like conversions, right? And you're seeing these now because there's so many like retail spaces that are empty that people are coming in and being like, oh, I'll just buy this retail space and then just make it into a storage facility. And you see these even in the smallest cities, you'll see them. You'll see this happen all the time. All right. So there's nothing wrong with that at all. And actually it's cheaper. I would think it's cheaper and faster to do it that way than to do like new construction, right? Because you already have that building. You're just going to have to get it rezoned and get it you know, built out. Okay. So now that you know the five ways, okay. So now how much money do you need for each of those? We talked a little bit about this, right? Wholesaling. You're wholesaling it. So, I mean, honestly, if you do exactly what I just said and define the storage facilities that way, then your marketing budget is literally zero. All it is your time. So it's all it is your time. Okay. So, so this one to fund them, it's not going to cost any money because essentially it's a wholesale deal. Now, in some cases, you may need to get transactional funding if you have to close on it for some reason, like do a double close. You could do transactional funding and that costs like, you know, 1 or 2% or something like this. Okay. But most of the time, like, you know, it's just to fund them is $0. Okay. Mismanaged facilities. We talked about this now. This is a private money and a hard money lending, right? So you're going to have to borrow money from other people or borrow from a hard money lender to fund the loan. And it's at a higher interest rate, right? Usually it's a very high interest rate. So you have to make sure when you buy that property, there's enough spread to compensate for that interest rate, okay? So that's the mismanaged facilities funding them. You need to go out and I mean, actually my coach, like 10 years ago, almost, I would say at least 9 or 10 years ago, I was running around like a crazy person doing all these rehabs and like trying to be this real estate investor or whatever. And I just told my coach, I was like, I feel like I'm running around like a crazy person. Like, I don't know what I'm doing anymore. And, you know, and he was like, and basically he said, like, Stacy is like, what are you? Are you like, what do you do? And I was like, I'm a rehabber. Like I flip homes and I rehab homes. And he was like, no, you're not a rehabber. And I was like, what? Yes, I am. He's like, no. I was like, he's like, what are you? And I was like, am I a residential redeveloper? Like what? I don't know. Am I a wholesaler? What am I? I'm a real estate investor. He's like, no, you're not. You're a fundraiser. The only way you're ever going to survive in this industry, and this is my tip for you, is if you learn how to raise money. The best investors are the most resourceful investors. When I say resourceful, I mean that you can pull 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 100, couple hundred thousand dollars out of your ass at any given time. So your goal as a real estate investor or a self-storage investor is to become the most resourceful investor you can be, right? Because if you can become resourceful and you become a fundraiser and learn how to raise money, then the sky is the limit. The sky is the limit. I was on a coaching call yesterday with a student and she's never done a deal at all, never done a deal. And she's in the process of working with an investor they're raising like from 10 to 15 million dollars together. And she's never done a deal before. All she did was she learned how to fundraise and she learned how to be resourceful and work with other investors to bring that money in. Okay. So that's what I'm talking about. If you can do that, if you learn how to fundraise, the sky is the limit in the real estate investing world. Okay. All right, so next thing, cash flowing properties. All right, so we talked about this. All right, this is the 80-20 rule, right? Most of the time, you got to put 20% down and you get funded the 80%. Highly recommend that you start out with a bank that's near where you're going to do this, right? So let's just say you find a storage facility out in, like, you know, in Jonesville, right? So you would want to be like going to the bank kind of in that area, local banks, regional banks in the area to get the funds for the loans. They love storage facilities, all right? They love it. All right, so don't go to a Wells Fargo or a Bank of America, because anyways, they're not lending any money anyways right now. You want to go to a local bank, and they'll literally, they'll eat out of your palm because they are desperate for loans right now, okay? And then also you can do SBA loans. So local or regional banks or SBA loans, okay? And SBA loves storage facilities. All right, so you can always do like, and they do a little bit less, like 15% down. Like, so you can do it that way. It's just that it takes forever. It could take up to 90 days to close on an SBA, on an SBA loan, okay? It just takes forever, right? Whereas a bank, you could probably close in like 30, 45 days, just so you know, okay? What else? Okay, finally, new construction. You just go to like a local or a regional bank to get a new construction loan or SBA. So these as well too. This is like, yeah, this is like a local bank or SBA for these, okay? And it's the 80-20 rule as well too, all right? For both of those, it's the 80-20 rule. And you want to go to a bank that will do a new construction loan, all right? So that, and there's, sometimes banks don't do that, so you have to kind of work. And honestly, I tell my students, if you have a good deal and you're like, you know you have a good deal, and you go to the lender and they're like, no, I don't want to do this deal, that's the wrong lender. It's not the deal. Now, you know, if it's not a good deal, the lender will be like, no, this deal sucks. But a lot of times there's lenders out there just like, no, I'm not going to do this kind of deal. Right. So I always tell my students, like, I had one student, he talked to like four or five different lenders. They were all like, no, no, no. And he finally talked to one. And he was like, hey, he's like, yeah, I'll do this deal. I'll close it easy. You know, so it's like, you know, you need to make sure that you're talking to a lot of lenders and, you know, and get their, and, you know, get their opinion on the deal, but like take heed because, you know, you could have a great deal, but it's just the wrong lender. Okay. And then finally, the develop and conversions. I mean, developing and like developing and doing conversions is actually quite expensive. All right. So this is like, if you have a lot of money, then go for it. Right. So like my student, she's like, I just want to do developing and conversions. That's all I want to do. And she's like, and I said, okay, well, you got to focus on the big bucks then. All right. She's like, all right, I'm going to focus on the big bucks. You know, and so she's like, she's doing, and there's like private equity investors, right? Private equity or syndication. Okay, for this kind of stuff, right? So like, I have a really good friend in the industry that he does developing, and what he does is he'll go, and actually when you do developing, and if you can like find really good deals, like even down in like downtown areas, now not in super big cities, but like, you know, like I have a friend that he was in, like he found like a warehouse kind of like in, I think it was like somewhere in Kentucky. He found like one of those, you know, those like, you know, like every one of those like towns where they have like those red brick like warehouses where like all the windows are like, you know, like smashed out and there's like graffiti all over them. There's like old buildings. Like, so he took one of those and he made it into a storage facility. Right. And that's what he does, is he converts those into storage facilities. It's like a three level building. And so he what he did not syndicate that money. He doesn't do funds, right? He doesn't do funds. What he does is he does private equity. So he pulls everybody together, but he gets a whole bunch of different lenders is what he does. Okay. So, and there's like a whole bunch, there's a whole bunch of different ways to do that. But essentially, just so you know, like usually these are going to be more expensive. And you have to learn how to raise money, and you have to learn, you know, how to like, and raise money legally is what I'm saying. Like, as in like following the SEC rules and stuff like this. Okay. All right. So that's with conversions, because that's funding them. Any questions on funding the five ways?